In this video, I will show 10 of the new and improved features in Parallels Desktop 15. Let's start with the new support for DirectX 11 and the conversion to metal-based graphics on the Mac. I will show this in the latest release of a popular game, Age of Empires. If you launch Age of Empires Definitive Edition in Parallels Desktop 14, you will see these two dialogues stating that the game will not run well. This warning was correct and the game was unplayable. Let's launch Age of Empires Definitive Edition in Parallels Desktop 15 with the new support for DirectX 11. As you can see, there are no warning dialogues, and the game runs well. I have played this game a lot on Windows PCs and it runs there at the same speed you see here in Parallels Desktop on the Mac. In this game, you train villagers, gather resources, create an army and a navy, and take over the world. Let's jump ahead and show you a naval battle. There are a number of other games, as well as computer-aided design and computer-aided manufacturing applications, that now run in Parallels Desktop 15 because of the support for DirectX and the use of Apple's Metal graphics. Let's turn our attention to the forthcoming macOS Catalina. Parallels Desktop 15 will fully support Catalina both as a host OS and a guest OS, when Catalina is released by Apple. Here you can see Catalina used as the host OS for Parallels Desktop 15, as well as a guest OS running in a Parallels Desktop virtual machine. In addition, Parallels Desktop 15 integrates support for several Catalina features. Here I am sending an email attachment using the new share menu item added by Parallels Desktop 15. Many Parallels Desktop users read their email in Outlook for Windows or the mail app built into Windows 10. This new feature will make it much easier for them to send an attachment by email. And here I am using the Paint application in Windows 10 to annotate a screenshot by integrating in the new screenshot process in macOS Mojave and macOS Catalina. But the Catalina feature that has created the largest interest is Sidecar, which enables you to use an iPad as a secondary Mac screen. Here I am turning on Sidecar on the Mac. Notice how the iPad screen immediately becomes a secondary Mac screen, complete with a dock and with special modifier keys along the left side. Parallels Desktop 15 has added a new menu to the green full screen button to make it especially easy to move Windows to the iPad. When you turn on tablet mode in Windows 10, you can use the Apple Pencil like the Surface Pro stylus. Here I am using the pressure sensitivity feature of the Apple Pencil with a painting application from the Microsoft Store. Parallels Desktop 15 supports all the other features of the Apple Pencil too, including tilt and double tap. When you launch a Windows app for which Parallels Desktop has touch bar support, like Microsoft Word, the touch bar gets displayed on the iPad. In June 2019, Microsoft released a new Windows 10 application that enables you to play Xbox games on your Windows 10 PC. Due to the improved graphics performance of Parallels Desktop 15 and the associated support for DirectX 11, this Xbox application runs fine in Parallels Desktop 15. You download Xbox games in this application and then run them. Here are a few moments of gameplay in one Xbox game.
What exactly is the emergency? The ground crew found an organism the ISA believed to be dangerous. We need to re-establish communication. Pick up your EMT. It's on the side. Okay. We are going to take a lander to Europa.
Microsoft will stop supporting Windows 7 in January 2020, so we believe many users will want to move to Windows 10 soon. This new wizard in Parallels Desktop 15 will help them to migrate from Windows 7 to Windows 10. Let's turn our attention to assisting new Parallels Desktop users in using Coherence with the new Coherence tutorial in Parallels Desktop 15. This tutorial will help new users get the most out of Coherence. Because this Coherence tutorial is intended for new users, it appears by default the first time Coherence is used. After this first appearance, it can be easily disabled to never appear again. A Parallels product that is bundled with Parallels Desktop is Parallels Toolbox. Parallels Toolbox provides a set of over 40 single-purpose tools that are always ready to streamline common computer tasks like taking a screenshot or hiding all the files on your desktop when you are about to give a presentation. I will show you two of the tools. A tool recently added to Parallels Toolbox is the Clipboard History tool, which remembers everything you have placed on the clipboard so you can paste it again easily. I have found this tool to be so useful that I have set it to automatically open when I start my Mac each day, and to remember my clipboard history for a month. The most used tool in Parallels Toolbox is the Download Video tool, which enables you to store on your Mac any video from YouTube, Facebook, and many other video sites. Here I am downloading a video from YouTube by dragging its URL to the Download Video tool. By default, the tool will download the highest resolution version of the video, and then notify you when the download is complete.
Who's that?
I hope you have enjoyed seeing these 10 new features in Parallels Desktop 15. Download a free 14-day trial of Parallels Desktop from this webpage. Thank you.